Students, in our previous video, we have seen block transfer which is of type non-overlap. So here in this tutorial, we are going to focus on the overlap block transfer, again with and without string instruction. So first we'll understand what do you mean by overlap. So overlap is something, some part of the source or some values of the source are being considered as a part of your destination. So let's say graphically, so as per the declaration, there is source block and destination block with these values 11 to 15 and 0, graphically it will look like this. So what happens in assembly, the order in which you define and declare your variables, in the same order it will assign a memory location. So here the memory locations are contiguously assigned. Okay. So source and destination are now with these values. So what we need to do, we need to overlap the contents. So what is overlapping? Let's consider, instead of starting my destination from this location, if I am starting from 14, so it means that two blocks of the source I have overlapped as a part of the destination. Okay, so now my destination will start from this point and it will continue up to 1 2 3 4 5, this, because here I have given the length as 5. Okay, so to highlight, my new destination is this. So this is called as overlapping of the block, and so considering some of the values of any block as a value of other block. Okay, so here we are considering two blocks or two values of the source are part of your destination. Now we'll focus on indexing part. So in programming, if you want to overlap it and if you want to show the overlapping, then it should reflect at the time of your display, block display, because from that location only you are going to display your block. So here we are doing or subtracting -2. Why? Because indexing wise, if you consider, if I just refer D block, if I just refer this destination block, it means 0th index, means this. But I want to point two locations to the previous, to this location. So indexing wise, it will be -1, -2. And that's why I will subtract the 2 from my D block, that is 0, -2. So I will point to 14. So from 14, my destination should get displayed. So while displaying the block, I am pointing it appropriately. Now let's see how it is affecting your block transfer. So this is the same logic which we have used in previous non-overlap block transfer. We'll see whether it is really working or not. So according to the previous logic, RSI is pointing to the starting location of source and RDI is pointing to the starting location of destination. So like that, your RSI and RDI are. RSI to RDI through AL, you are going to transfer the data. So with that, 11 will be moved to this, 12 will be moved to this location, 13 will get moved to this location, 14 will get, sorry, what we are moving to the destination. So already our destination is starting from this. So we need to point to the new destination instead of this. So please correct it. We will point our destination to the new destination, that is to the 14. So our data will be 11 will get stored here, 12 will get stored here, 13 will get stored here, 14 instead of 14, now 11 will get copied here and 12 will get copied here. So what we are getting in destination, we are not getting whatever the original content of the source is. So this is not a correct type of block transfer. So we need to work on some other strategy. So what we can do, so one of the simplest way is what, instead of pointing your RSI and RDI to the starting location of these blocks, point them to the last location. So here my RSI will get point to this last location of source, and here my RDI will get point to the last location of new destination. Okay, and now we'll transfer the data from RSI to RDI. So 15, it will get moved to this location, instead of now incrementing RSI RDI, we need to decrement it. So RSI will point here, RDI will point here, 14 will get copied here, likewise 13 will get copied here, 12 will get copied in the place of 15, and 11 will get copied in the place of 14. And so you will get a 11 to 15 as your new destination after a block transfer, provided there will some overlapping in your source. It has to be there because two blocks of the source, we have already overlapped with the destination. So there will be some overlapping of the values after block transfer as well. So we'll logically we will work on it. So pointing to the last location is something, because indexing start from zero. So RSI will point to the last location of this source. Graphically we'll come to know that, yes, where we need to point RDI to the second location. So we'll add two in it. This is same. Now instead of increment in, here we will decrement RSI RDI, decrement counter, and repeat from this back label. Okay. So we'll just check whether this logic is working or not. So see, source is 11 to 15 and before transfer destination is 14, 15 and remaining are 0. So that's whatever we have figured out graphically. After transfer, source contents are get overlap. Last two blocks are overlap with first two. But if you observe, the complete destination is same as your source before transfer. So this is your correct block transfer. Okay. So this is how your overlap block transfer without using string instruction is. Now if you want to work with the string instruction, then we'll just need to modify the block transfer process. Like previously also we have used move SB. We need to repeat the task, so we will use repeat. And now instead of here CLD, here we are going to use STD. So what STD will help us, it will set the direction flag and it will help in decrementing RSI and RDI. Okay. So we'll just check, we are getting the output. Yes, we are getting the same output.